updated their website. I can just go and click on here. From the heavy, meaning the lifesteal, Eldar. Eldar is only 30% effective on the lifesteal Eldar. If I recall, it was always like 13, 14, 15. And I was doing things to try to like see if I could make that go up, like using Fountain on Kwang, and it didn't help. I don't know. What up, Duck Knights? Got the popcorn out. See how much I'm gonna rage today. That's going pretty good. I know Kalari's on the right side, I just saw him.
Ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
I've seen the new path. Yeah, I just looked at it. I'm excited just to see it on Kwang.
slain. An enemy has been slain.
Yeah, Kwang too. I mean, yeah, Sev. You think it's gonna be best on Bellica? Why so?
Enemy has been slain. Attack. An enemy has been slain.
I don't know what this Sev is doing. He just went and dove tower and killed himself. Yeah, with her pass, it's going to be nuts. Oh yeah, because she, Bellica already gets, extra energy power on her basics because her drone. So that's gonna add to that. I was thinking Kwang because, his basic attacks, like, it's not his focus, but now, like, that just adds to his kit, right? Now he does basic damage with extra energy, plus he has a lot of energy damage. And I want to see if it scales, like, does it help his lifesteal? Because that card has attack speed, right? Normally you don't build attack speed on Kwang, the way Kwang is in this game. I'm like, will that help his lifesteal? I was trying to find if his lifesteal scales with anything else. Like, does it just scale with his levels, or does it scale with his attack power, or does it scale with his energy power? Like, how do you get his lifesteal to go up on his basic? I played a ton of Kwang in Paragon, like Monolith, but this game, like, they changed him, so it's like, I don't know, I just haven't really felt it. I think Sevarov got frustrated and left. For fun, I would, or for a lot of reason.
Enemy tower destroyed.
I mean, I play for fun. The problem is I only have fun when I'm winning.
Allied tower destroyed.
Like, I could frag out, right? But a lot of the times
an
I get blamed.
Enemy has been slain.
Like, you could be having the most impact on the game, taking all the towers, and the team will still find a reason to blame you. So then it ends up making, like, I end up not having fun.
An ally has been slain. An ally has been slain. An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
Just thought she was getting away. Gotta watch mid while I take this blue, make sure one of them don't come for me. Here she comes.
Has been slain.
Oh shit, I get E instead. I don't know why he keeps wasting it all like that.
An allied tower is under attack. Is under attack. Been slain.
Why did it take Bale off of? Oh, hey, where is he? 49. I was playing off lane Kwang. I don't typically like building full mage, but I figured I would try it out. Typically, I like try to build Bale second, and I try to get like green boots. But I mean, to be fair, it worked out early game. Like, I went boots first. I went pin boots first, and this Seb made a couple of dumb decisions. But I just bold with it. But no, I was playing off lane. Yeah, so this Sev, like, tried to 1v1 me, like, early game, like, within the first 2 minutes, right? And I got him low enough. He didn't want to go back to base. He made a choice to stay, so I killed him. But then he never came back. He went right lane, because my team was grouping up in the right lane. And he never came back, so I took his tower within, like, under 10 minutes. So I just kept building energy damage. Enemy has been slain. My energy's not doing much. Already it was like starting to fall. The reason I don't like building mage with Kwang is because it feels like his energy damage is never that high. Like I felt like I had Eldritch Flame in these boots, and I wasn't really doing a lot of damage to that Severog. It was weird.
Enemy has been slain. Enemy tower destroyed.
Manowins and white boots first, going mage. Oh, so people go, see, everybody always has their differences, right? If I would have said that yesterday, and they would have been like, no. So you say white boots and mandolin first, huh? Alright. I'll do that next game. I'm gonna play a lot of Kwang today just because I'm tired of playing Kalari. Like, fragging is fun, but I'm kinda getting bored of Kalari. Not a lot of people play Kwang anymore, so I'm gonna play some Kwang, and next game I'll go white boots and mandolin first. I could kill her, but I don't like staying and taking a bunch of poke damage, letting the Severog rotate on me. Remnant is hybrid.
Allied tower is under attack.
Look at them. They're all looking for me. Like, guys.
enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain.
Why boots are better on it. ER and mana. Yeah, that makes sense. Also, y'all reach right in it. 100%. Makes sense. Now I well, thanks for making me feel stupid, Vile. Fuck. You have to be rude, bro. You have to be rude, okay? No, I'm just kidding. Nah, it makes complete sense. I melted that Murdoch. I didn't even have to ult. I didn't realize that my E would kill him. Like, I tethered him and then E'd him and he died. I didn't realize. Either I didn't realize how low he was or I didn't realize how much damage it would do to him. So, I'm gonna have to. What level was he? He's level 10? I'm level 12? I feel like I'm not getting any health back when I basic attack.
An enemy has been slain.
Is that not a thing anymore to get health back on your basic attacks? I'm not doing any damage to him. And all he has is Bale and Boots. Guy was here and didn't get green. Why didn't he get this?
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Ass.
What a dummy, bro. Then I will rest. I will rest my weary mind. I will rest my weary mind after a long and arduous battle. I'm just gonna sit here until he gets here. Let's have fun today, guys!
Enemy has been slain.
That's some fucking fun.
Ally has been slain.
Get fountain. Yeah, Okay, spell vamp too, but it's 30% effective. Isn't his E, is his E AoE or no? His past spell vamp stack with Queen's vamp? I think it does stack, and maybe that's why I was getting health before.
Allied tower destroyed.
25 minutes in and I lost him. Like, he could have just left. He didn't really need to do that, but okay.
Has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
I could go take this left tower, but it's not fun. We're having fun today.
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Double kill.
Look how fast she was moving, bro. Like, you're not hitting her with anything when she does that shit. Could have killed her, I think, just now. And Bellica used her knockup. I should have just ulted and killed her. No, I'm not out of bronze yet. I was close. Over the weekend, I won a bunch of games and I made it to like 980. So I had hoped to continue. And then Monday, I played 7 games and won 1. With, like, between disconnects, people surrendering. And all kinds of bullshit, like, I end up losing, like, all games except for one. I'll leave. Mayor, why would you go in there? This is why people lose games. Like, that wasn't a smart engage, so we all left.
Has been slain.
Some of them are still in there.
An ally has been slain. An ally has been slain. Has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
Yeah, it's definitely hard, bro. Like, and like, it's always like extreme ups and extreme downs. Like, there's never any in the middle, bro. Like, one day I'll get games, and every game it'll be new players, right? Or every game it'll be the same fucking type of trolls, you know what I'm saying? And it's like every game, I'll get these guys on my team, and the opposite team never gets these guys. I played Saturday and Sunday, and like, it was, you know, usually the weekends are kind of the rough, rough ones, but Monday, bro, I lost all that elo. I went from like low 800 to high 900s, and then Monday lost all of it in 7 games. And I played twice as many games to get it all up. Like, it feels bad, bro. Like, it just seems like the way the game is set up, it's not meant for me to climb.
Enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
Yeah, so all day yesterday, people were surrendering. It was either I had to surrender, or people were new.
Enemy tower destroyed.
Like, I got all of it. I think we played 10 games yesterday, and maybe I won one or two. And all of it was that, was what you're saying, people surrendering. Like, we surrendered a lot of games. One game surrendered before I could even, like, I was winning my lane. I was playing Greystone, and, like, you know, like, I was running this dude, and our team died 3 times, or 4 times. We only died 4 times. It wasn't even 10 minutes yet. And the game just ended, like, in my face. I saw the vote go up, I saw one person vote to surrender, and then the game
has
just
been
ended.
Slain. Double kill. An ally has been slain. Triple kill.
None of them have lifesteal, right? Except only one that regens life right now is Morgesh. So I don't feel as though I need Chest Piece or Remnant.
An allied tower is under attack. Allied tower destroyed.
So they've pretty much tied up the game. On towers. I've never even had a good experience stacking, bro. Every experience I've had with stacking is you get a bunch of bronze people, right? So you got 5 bronze people stacking. Now, the question is, are they the good bronze or are they the, like, you know, the unskilled bronze? Well, usually it's, you know, there's not too many of us bronze players that are actually, like, you know, kind of know the game. So then you got, you know, it might as well just be a random squad of bronzes. And then what happens is when you're 5 stacked, you get stacked against people that are better than you because you're stacked. And you end up getting your fucking mouth curb stomped. So stacking has never been a good idea for me, bro.
An enemy has been slain.
Alright, I don't want these guys to catch up. I'm going to start pushing left lane. What's gonna happen is I can already see it now. Like, my team is just, they're gonna continue to fight, and they're overconfident, and they're gonna lose the fights, and this enemy team is gonna catch up. guy just uses his ult, like, doesn't even give a fuck. I think he took cream.
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
Where's the rest of their team? Still four people up. One's here, one's in mid, two's in mid.
An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
Do I get APOC? Or do I get more defense? Fuck it, I'm just gonna get APOC.
An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain. An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Double kill. Been slain. Double kill. An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain.
I don't got enough space. I'm getting rid of this. I feel like I want to buy this gate scroll just in case. I have to like blink to a tower. I'm gonna mark me right now. Mark my words. 54 minutes into the stream. 40 minutes into this game. I feel like I should have bought gate scroll because I feel like the team's gonna fight and the team's gonna push. I feel like our team's gonna fight, we're gonna lose, and then the enemy team's gonna push and take another one of our tier 2s, and I could save it with a gate scroll because I'm gonna push a lane by myself, and I could just gate scroll back and save a tower.
An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Slain. Enemy ally has been slain.
Destroyed. I'm waiting for them to all go back, but they're still fighting. You see, they're all still fighting. I don't know why Bear's still up there.
An enemy has been slain. Enemy tower destroyed.
Nobody went to Prime. They all stayed too long and died. Alright, last card, guys. What do I get? PS or damage? Do I get Matlam? What has the most damage? More power! More power! Oh, let me get Mana Lens. How about that? And now I need 1,800 gold. They want a group? We'll group. I'm late, though. They went into the fight without their Murdoch.
An enemy has been slain.
Warlock's Opus would be. I mean, ally has been I think slain. I would have went Opus. Opus has a lot of power, though, right? Because people always say Opus is useless.
But... An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An enemy has been slain. An ally has been slain. Double kill. Thank you.
came to the party late and still got a double kill. You know why? Because I didn't go after a tank like the rest of the team did.
Enemy tower destroyed. An allied tower is under attack. An ally has been slain.
Why is no one going after Murdoch? He was doing so good not typing this match. You see how they all ignore Murdoch? Like, why? Why is everyone ignoring Murdoch? Why does Murdoch walk through a whole battle and no one touches him? You know what I'm saying? Like, fucking stupid.